I'm just quickly going to go through a couple of scriptures, and then we're going to teach about it and then close. 2 Corinthians 3 verse 12. Now Paul spoke to all the people and said, people, the hope you must now have is the gospel of God. What is the gospel? That Christ paid the price for you on the cross. The hope we now have is that one day we will be like him. The hope that we have is that when Jesus comes again, or when he is revealed, he will be revealed through us. John also says, when Christ comes again, when he is revealed through us, we will be like him. Who wants to be like Jesus? And then all of us, that is the goal we have in life. That is the vision we have in life. Many people don't have that vision. Yamon, what do you mean? Many people just have a vision to be the best Christian they can possibly be. That's not a vision, that's a goal. What happens when you reach that goal? Then it's just over. Then you no longer have a vision. Well, what happens when you become like Jesus? People around you will get saved. Pray for the sick, they'll get healed. So the lie from the devil is you have to be the best Christian you can possibly be. God never said we have to be that. God's plan always is for us to become more like Jesus. It has always been the plan for us, is to become more like Jesus. Not to be the best Christian you can possibly be. Because if you get to the stage where you want to be the best person you can possibly be, then it's going to be about you. Do you understand? It's never about us. It's about God. Then you will have, what's trots in over here? Pride. You will have pride. I'm a good Christian. It's not about you. It's not about what you've done. It's about what Jesus has done on the cross. So the plan is to become more like Jesus, less of yourself. That's why Paul says, I am crucified with Christ. And the life I now live, I live in Christ. It's no longer I that live. I'm no longer important. It's not important if I'm a good Christian. I just want to be like Christ. Paul said, if you go to Philippians 3, it's one of my favorite scriptures. He says that everything I once had, that could have meant anything to me, I now see as rubbish. I have no use for it. But there's one thing I cherish, and what is that? Is to know Jesus Christ and to become acquainted with him. That's the only thing I desire, only thing I want. For me, that's the scripture of my life. That's what I love. Now, 2 Corinthians 3, verse 12. Now, hear what it says. Since we have such a glorious hope, say hope. It says hope is joyful and confident expectation. Since we have such a glorious hope, we have joyful and confident expectation. We speak freely and openly and fearlessly. And it goes on, it says, nor do we act like Moses who put a veil over his face so that the Israelites might not gaze upon the finish and the vanishing and the splendor on it. Now, I'm going to run through this quickly. I'm not going to read it again. We read it last week. When Moses were given the agreement with God, when Moses came down the mountain, what happened? His face was shining with a brilliant kind of light, not the sun, moon, and stars or a flashlight. And then the light that shone out of the face of Moses was a glorious light. And if you read on, the Bible here says, but the people, whenever they read the law, all of them, they had a veil over their eyes and they had a veil over their heart. So the law kan wat gegooi was oor hulle oë en oor hulle harte. Want die wet, die 10 gebooie, die wet het hulle blind gemaak, omdat hulle nooit al die 10 gebooie kon nakom nie. The 10 commandments became a curse to the people because they could never reach that goal. They could never reach that vision of being completely whole and blameless according to the law. Never. So it became a curse. And I'm gonna share it with you just now. Galatians 5 verse 5. Hear what it says. But before we read it, it says that Moses had light shining out of his face. But then the Bible goes on. It says, so that is the first agreement, the first covenant. But it says the first covenant had its faults, had defects. And that's why God wanted to establish a new covenant with us. Not using the law or the Ten Commandments or the word of the prophets. God wanted to give us a new covenant, a new agreement. And as we spoke last week, if you weren't here, please get the DVD, go and listen to it. What is the new covenant? It's no longer if you do, then I will do. The new covenant, or it's actually a testament, where Jesus says, I did it all on the cross, just believe. And it shall be given unto you. I died on the cross for you. You can no longer be holy on your own, but you have to believe in me, and then I will make you holy. Believe that my blood is over you, and then you are holy according to the law as well. We spoke about it and said the law is no longer in front of you. But the Bible says that when we turn around, because the Israelites, when they looked into the law, they were guilty and there were a veil over their eyes, their minds, their thought life, and there was a veil over their hearts. But the Bible says, but when the people turn around, repent. Repent means turn around and move in the opposite direction. So when the people didn't look into the law anymore or into the face of Moses, they turned around and you look into the face of Jesus, shining with much more glory as a brilliant light. And when we look into that light, the face of Jesus, we change. And the law is no longer in front of us, but when we turn around and look into Jesus' face, the law is engraved on our minds and on our hearts. And the Bible says the veil which falls onto our eyes when you look into the law, which says you are guilty, not good enough, when you turn around, that veil, die laken wat oor jou oë en oor jou hart is, vat God dan weg. En dan laat jy toe om in die gesig van Jesus in te kyk. En sy gesig sê, jy is vry, jy is skoon gewas. Die wet sê, jy is goed genoeg en jy word veroordeel. Maar ek kyk in die Bybel sê vir my, Jesus sê, ek is reeds veroordeel vir jou onthalwe. I am judged for you. I became a curse, so that you don't have to have a curse in your life. So, remember the light, remember the glory. Galatians 5 verse 5, let's go to 5 verse 4. It says, if you seek to be justified and declared righteous and to be given a right standing with God through the law, you are brought to nothing. And so separated from Christ, you have fallen away from grace. Now hear what it says in verse 5. For we, not relying on the law, the Ten Commandments and the word of the prophets, not relying on the law. So I say, ons vertrou nie op die wet om ons heilig te maak meer nie, want het kan nie. Ons vertrou in wat Jesus gedoen het op die kruis, dit maak ons heilig. Verstaan? So dit gaan nie oor my eie werke nie, werke werk nie. Amen? Maar geloof werk in Christus. So dit sê, for we not relying on the law, but through the Holy Spirit's help, by faith, belief, anticipate and wait for the blessing and good for which our righteousness and right standing with God, our conformity to His will and purpose, thought and action, causes us to do what? Causes us to hope. So he says, the law will take away all hope. Die wet sal alle hoop uit jou hart uitvat, want jy kom achter, as jy in die wet vastkyk, is jy nie goed genoeg en jy verloor alle hoop. Hoe kan ek ooit soos Christus wees? Die wet sê ek maak het nie, die wet sê ek is nie goed genoeg nie, ek is nie heilig genoeg nie. Ek gaan nooit soos Jesus kan wees nie. Ek gaan nooit meer soos hy kan word nie, so ek verloor alle hoop. But yet Paul says, but we by faith anticipate and believe in Jesus. And when we believe in him, he says you are holy, you are blameless. And that gives us hope to become more like Christ. That gives us a vision. Amen? Quickly go to Ephesians 1 verse 18. Now, do you remember what we spoke about? We said that the face of Moses shone like a light. But whenever the people looked into the law which Moses brought, a veil fell over their eyes or their minds and fell over their hearts. So they were completely closed up. They could not see the light of the glory of God. They only saw the law telling them you're not good enough. They couldn't see the light. So the Bible says we have to turn around, not look into the law, but look into the face of Jesus, shining like a brilliant light. And when you look into the face of Jesus, you will become like him. Amen? He will tell you, there's hope. You can become like me. I've washed you in my blood. I've made you clean. Just keep on looking into my face. Because my face is full of grace, full of love, full of forgiveness. When you look into the law, it says, you're not good enough, guilty, condemned. So he says, turn around and look into my face. Now hear what it says, the scripture. This is amazing. This really blessed me last night. It says, Ephesians 1 verse 18. It says, by having the eyes of your heart flooded with light. Oh, you have to see this. Let's read it again. By having the eyes of your heart, your heart has eyes. That's why the veil, whenever they looked into the law, there was a veil over their hearts. To blind the eyes that was in their hearts. Do you understand? So guilt will always blind you from God's grace. What do you mean? Die wet sê jy is goed genoeg nie. Jy kom kerk toe daai dag, jy voel nie goed genoeg nie. Ons het 'n laken oor jou hart gegooi, jy word verblind in jou hart. Jy word verblind in jou gedagtes. Persoon sê kom vorentoe, ek wil vir jou bid dat jy gesond kan word. Jy stap vorentoe, maar jy kan nie insien hoekom God jou gaan genees nie. Ek stem ons nie goed genoeg nie. In jou hart voel jy, maar Here, hoekom wil jy my gesond maak? Ek is 'n sondaar, ek is nie goed genoeg nie. So jy kyk in die wet en jy oordeel jouself, ek is nie goed genoeg nie. So jy kan nie verstaan, jy kan nie sien hoekom God jou wil gesond hê nie. Jy kan nie sien hoekom wil hy vir jou sterf nie. Maar nou draai jy om en jy kyk in die gesig van Jesus vas en die Bybel sê dat laken word dan weggevat. En ewe skielik kyk in die gesig van Jesus en jy kom agter maar hy het dit vir jou gedoen op die kruis. Jy kom agter maar hy het vir jou gesterf. Hy het sy bloed laat vloei. Hy het sy liggaam laat oopskeer op die kruis vir jou. Ewe skielik verstaan jy, Here, as gevolg daarvan wil jy my gesond hê. Dankie. So the eyes of your heart becomes flooded. The light shines into your heart so intense that it floods your whole heart. That it floods your whole mind. And as a light shines into your mind, all the darkness, all the guilt, condemnation just flows away and runs away because the light of the face of Jesus is shining into your heart, shining into your mind. And everything which is wicked just goes away because you believe and look into the face of Jesus. Quickly read again. By having the eyes of your heart flooded with light. Now hear what it says. So that you can know and understand the hope. By having the eyes of your heart flooded with light. So that you can know and understand the hope to which he has called you. And how rich is his glorious inheritance in the saints. He set apart once. And so that you can know and understand what is the immeasurable and unlimited and surpassing greatness of his power in and for us who believe as demonstrated in the working of his mighty strength. Now what does it say? It says the law tells us you're not good enough. You don't understand what God has for you. You lose a vision. You lose hope. I can never become like Christ. But Paul said, you have to become like Christ. But now I turn around. I no longer find myself guilty, condemned. I look into the face of Jesus. When I look into the face of Jesus, suddenly something happens in my heart. It says, if just believe in me and you are holy, you are blameless. Just believe in me. And as you believe in me and not look at your own life, not look at yourself, but you keep on looking at me, the more hope you will start to have in your life. What is hope? It is exceeding confident, and confidence in what? In the promises of God. Why do people no longer believe in the promises of God? They've lost hope. Why did they lose hope? Because they look at themselves. They don't look at Jesus. Because the light on the face of Moses started to fade away. But the Bible says, but when you look into the face of Jesus, that light will shine into your eyes, into the eyes of your heart, and it will completely flood you. Just think of a light as a river flowing into your heart and flooding your whole life. That's a desire I have. That's how we're going to become more like him. Hebrews 7 verse 19, just quickly. Hebrews 7 verse 19. Now hear what it says. Now this might be a shocker to some people, but this is a confirmation. Hear what it says. Hebrews 7 verse 19. It says, for the law never made anything perfect. Go sê dit weer. For the law never made anything perfect. Die wet het nog nooit enigiets perfect gemaak nie. Maar Paulus sê, wees perfect soos God perfect is. Hoe? Jy moet hoop hê. Dat Jesus klaar op die kruis alles vir jou gedoen het. As jy daai hoop verloor, verloor jy alles. Let's read again. For the law never made anything perfect. Now hear what it says. But instead, a better hope is introduced through which we now come close to God. Oh, you must get excited about this. So let's say, ons het eens nie hoop gehad, maar nou is 'n nuwe en 'n betere hoop vir ons oopgebreek. Wat 'n hoop is dit?